Good morning, students. So in the last class we have solved up to 6th question. So in today's class we'll start with the 7th one. The given problem it is f of x which is equal to mod x plus 3 if x less than or equal to minus 3 and minus 2x if x lies between minus 3 and plus 3 and 6x plus 2 if x greater than or equal to 3. So here overall we get 5 cases if you consider c as any real number. So now the first case it is c less than minus 3 and the second case it is c equal to minus 3. Third case will be c lies between minus 3 and plus 3, c greater than minus 3 and less than plus 3, and then fourth case will be c greater than 3 and the last fifth case will be c which is equal to 3. And now for c less than minus 3, c lies between minus 3 and plus 3 and c greater than 3, the function will be continuous. Now we have to check the continuity at c equal to minus 3 and c equal to plus 3. That is why, so I will be taking only the two cases. See here. So here at c which is equal to minus 3. So here we will have to go for the LHL, RHL and the value of the function. So at c equal to minus 3, what is the function now? F of c which is equal to, it is mod c plus 3. So now f of, what is c here? It is minus 3. So mod minus 3 plus 3. Mod minus 3 will be plus 3. 3 plus 3 will be 6. So here the value of the function it is 6. Now I will have to go for the left hand limit. So LHL which is equal to limit x tends to minus 3 then minus f of x which is equal to limit x tends to minus 3 minus. Minus 3 minus means less than minus 3. For less than minus 3, the function is mod x plus 3. The function is mod x plus 3. So apply the limit here. We get, so minus 3 minus means it is almost equal to minus 3. So mod minus 3 plus 3. So mod minus 3 it is plus 3. 3 plus 3 will be 6. Next I will have to go for the right hand limit. RHL which is equal to, so it is minus 3 plus. So limit x tends to minus 3 plus f of x. So RHL which is equal to limit x tends to minus 3 plus, minus 3 plus means here x has to be, or c has to be greater than minus 3. For greater than minus 3, the function it is minus 2x. See here, x greater than minus 3, it is minus 2x. So RHL which is equal to, apply the limit here, minus 2. In place of x, I will have to write minus 3. So RHL which is equal to minus into minus will be plus, it is 6. So see here, LHL is equals to RHL, that is equal to value of the function. Therefore, the function is continuous at c equal to minus 3. So therefore, LHL is equals to RHL which is equal to f of minus 3, which is equal to f of minus 3, the function is continuous, the function is continuous at c is equals to minus 3, at c equal to minus 3. Now we will have to check the continuity at c equal to plus 3. Again here we will have to go for LHL, RHL and the value of the function. So let us go for that now. At C which is equal to plus 3, at C is equals to plus 3, so let us go for f of C. So at C equal to 3, the function, it is 6x plus 2, 6c plus 2. So now f of 3, it is 6 into 3, in place of C I will have to write 3, 6 into 3 it is 18, 18 plus 2, it is 20, the value of the function, it is 20. Now we will have to go for the left hand limit, LHL which is equal to limit x tends to 3 minus f of x. So here LHL which is equal to limit x tends to 3 minus f of x. 3 minus means here x has to be less than 3. For x less than 3, the function, it is minus 2x. So it is minus 2x. Now LHL which is equal to, apply the limit here. So minus 2, I write it as it is. So in place of x, I will have to write 3. So minus 2 into 3 will be minus 6. So let's go for the right hand limit. Now RHL which is equal to limit x tends to 3 plus, x tends to 3 plus f of x. So RHL which is equal to limit x tends to 3 plus, 3 plus means it is greater than 3. X greater than 3, the function, it is 6x plus 2. So here RHL which is equal to apply the limit here, 6 into 3, it is 18 plus 2. So 6 into 3 plus 2, RHL which is equal to, how much we get? 20. But LHL is not equal to RHL, therefore the function is not continuous at C equal to 3. Therefore LHL is not equal to RHL, LHL is not equal to RHL, hence the function is not continuous. Hence, the function is not continuous at C is equals to 3. So, here the function is continuous at all the points except at C equal to 3. That means C equal to 3 or x equal to 3 is the only point of discontinuity. This implies x equal to 3 is the only point of discontinuity. So this is all about the seventh problem. So pause the video to note it down. The next question, it is eighth one. F of x which is equal to mod x by x if x not equal to 0, and 0 if x equal to 0. So here in the numerator we have modulus function, that means we have to rewrite. So he has given the condition as x not equal to 0, that means x can be less than 0 or greater than 0 but not equal to 0. So let us rewrite the given function. Rewrite the given function, rewrite the given function. So now we get f of x which is equal to, so mod x becomes minus x if x less than 0. So it is minus x divided by, the denominator remains as it is, the thing only changes is the numerator. So condition is if x less than 0 and then 0 if x equal to 0 and then now see here. So the numerator mod x becomes plus x, so it is x by x if x greater than 0, if x greater than 0. So here x and x get cancels, here also x and x get cancels, here we get minus 1 and in the third case we get plus 1. So f of x which is equal to, so it is minus 1 if x less than 0 and 0 if x which is equal to 0 and 1 if x greater than 0. So now again we get three cases here, c less than 0, c is equals to 0 and c greater than 0. The function will be anyway continuous for c less than 0 and c greater than 0. So that is why I will not check the continuity at these two points. So now we have to check the continuity at c equal to 0, because around 0 the function is changing. That is why we have to go for left hand limit as well as the right hand limit. So see here, at c which is equal to 0, at c is equals to 0. So what will be the function now? f of c will be 0. So that is f of 0 will be 0. Now I will have to go for the left hand limit, which is equal to limit x tends to 0 minus f of x, and then LHL which is equal to limit x tends to 0 minus. 0 minus means less than 0. For less than 0, the function it is minus 1. So minus 1. So now see here, the limit of a constant it is constant. So we get minus 1. So now we will have to go for, okay, now we will go for the RHL, right hand limit. Now RHL which is equal to limit x tends to 0 plus f of x. So let us go ahead with this. So RHL which is equal to limit x tends to 0 plus, what is f of x now? For 0 plus, 0 plus means it is greater than 0, the function it is 1. So it is 1. So now limit of a constant is always a constant, RHL which is equal to 1. So see here, the LHL is not equal to RHL, therefore LHL is not equal to RHL, hence the function is not continuous at c is equals to 0. Therefore, x equal to 0 is the only point of discontinuity that we have to write at the end. This implies x equal to 0 is the only point of discontinuity. So this is all about the 8th problem. So pause the video to note it down. Well, so take the 9th as an assignment. So I will solve the 10th problem. F of x which is equal to x plus 1 if x greater than or equal to 1 and x square plus 1 if x less than 1. Again we get three cases here, c less than 1, c greater than 1 and c equal to 1. The function will be continuous for c less than 1 and c greater than 1. So now we have to check the continuity at c equal to 1. So I will be doing only one case now. See here, f of x which is equal to x plus 1, if x greater than or equal to 1, and then x square plus 1 if x less than 1. So now I will have to go for at c which is equal to 1, at c is equals to 1. So what is f of c will be c plus 1. So at x equal to 1, the function is x plus 1. So now we are taking c, where c is any real number. So now replace x by c, we get c plus 1. So f of 1 which is equal to, in place of c I will have to write 1 plus 1 will be 2. So this is the value of the function. Next we have to go for LHL and RHL. So LHL which is equal to limit x tends to 1 minus f of x. So now see here, LHL is equal to limit x tends to 1 negative f of x. 1 negative means less than 1. The function is x square plus 1. So now LHL is equals to, so apply the limit now, 1 minus means almost equal to 1. So in place of x I will have to write 1. So 1 square plus 1, LHL is equals to 2. So next we will have to go for the right hand limit. So now RHL which is equal to limit x tends to 1 plus f of x, 1 plus f of x. So RHL which is equal to limit x tends to 1 plus one plus means it is greater than 1. For x greater than 1, the function is x plus 1. So RHL which is equal to, apply the limit now, we get 1 plus 1, RHL is equals to 2. So see here, the LHL, RHL and the value of the function, all three coincide. That means the function is continuous at c which is equal to 1. So here, therefore LHL which is equal to RHL, LHL is equals to RHL which is equal to value of the function, it is f of 1. So all the three are equal, therefore this implies the function is continuous. The function is continuous at x which is equal to 1. So the function is continuous for c less than 1, c greater than 1, c equal to 1. That means there is no point of discontinuity for the given function. Here I will have to write. Hence there is no point of discontinuity. So this is all about the 10th problem. So pause the video to note it down. Well, so the 11th problem, it is f of x which is equal to x cube minus 3 if x less than or equal to 2 and x square plus 1 if x greater than 2. So we will write the given function f of x which is equal to x cube minus 3 if x less than or equal to 2 and x square plus 1 if x greater than 2, if x greater than 2. So now see here, again we get three cases now, c less than 2, c equal to 2 and c greater than 2. The function will be continuous for c less than 2 and c greater than 2, and we have to check the continuity at c which is equal to 2. So at c which is equal to 2, now f of c which is equal to c cube minus 3. So c value it is 2 here, f of 2 which is equal to 2 cube minus 3. So f of 2 which is equal to 2 cube will be 8, 8 minus 3 will be 5. So this is the value of the function. Now we will have to go for limit of a function, LHL which is equal to limit x tends to 2 minus f of x, now left hand limit which is equal to limit x tends to 2 minus f of x. So what is 2 minus? It is less than 2. The function is x cube minus 3. So now LHL which is equal to, so in place of x I write 2 cube minus 3. So LHL which is equal to 8 minus 3 will be 5. So now we will have to go for the right hand limit. Now RHL which is equal to limit x tends to 2 plus f of x. Now RHL which is equal to limit x tends to 2 positive means it is x greater than 2. The function is x square plus 1. So it is x square plus 1. So now RHL which is equal to, so here 2 square plus 1 RHL which is equal to 2 square will be 4, 4 plus 1 will be 5. So here LHL is 5, RHL is 5 and the value of the function that is also 5. All three coincide, therefore the function is continuous at c equal to 2. So therefore the function is continuous for c less than 2, c greater than 2 and equal to 2. That means there is no point of discontinuity. So here I will have to write, this implies LHL which is equal to RHL which is equal to f of 2. Therefore the function is continuous at c which is equal to 2. So what does it indicate now? There is no point of discontinuity for this particular problem. Hence there is no point of discontinuity because it is continuous at all the points. Discontinuity. So this is all about the 11th problem. So take the 12th and 13th as an assignment problem. In the tomorrow's class, I'll be starting with the 14th one.